To every tie of honor bound, worldwide our fellowship is constant found. Greetings. My name is Yashwant Prakash Vyas. My pronouns are he, him, his, himself. I'm an assistant director for diversity resources in the Division of Diversity, Equity, Inclusion here at the University of Iowa. I'm the president and chapter coordinator for the Alpha Tau chapter of Phi Beta Delta Honor Society for International Scholars. I also serve as a director and regional vice president for the US Midwest region of the society on the board of directors. It is with my affiliations that I call this special meeting of the Alpha Tau chapter here in Iowa City to order. Our first order of duty is to remind ourselves of the history of Phi Beta Delta, symbolism of our crest, and the objectives of Phi Beta Delta. My friends, honor societies such as ours date back many years and have a rich and meaningful history. Phi Beta Delta has a unique position in scholarly honor societies because of its internationalism. Phi Beta Delta first established at California State University at Long Beach in 1986, was chartered in 1987 with 38 founding chapters. It is the first national honor society dedicated to recognizing scholarly achievement in international education. The mission of Phi Beta Delta is to recognize achievement in international educational interchange and to serve as a catalyst to increase the recognition, credibility, and importance of the international experience and develop a network of individuals involved in international experiences. Our founders hoped, in their own words, that Phi Beta Delta would be a catalyst in increasing the recognition of the importance of international experience, especially in education, and that the society would connect internationally minded individuals throughout the world. These aspirations are well embodied in our crest, to which I now call your earnest attention. The crest is depicted on a shield, which reminds us to ever defend academic freedom. Superimposed in a sunburst, reminding us that all peoples are under the same sun and from it draw strength. The three Greek letters stand for philometia, the love of knowledge, biothrimonia, the valuing of human life, and diaphrine, the quest for excellence. The open book embraces all the wisdom of the world's varied cultures. The torch is significant of the leadership shown by our members. The motto, Scintia Mutua Mundi, is translated as the world's shared knowledge. Our colors are brilliant red and gold. The red is emblematic of the common lifeblood of all humankind. The gold represents the energy of the sun from which we universally draw life. In conferring the medal of our society upon you today, we seek to recognize your commitment to our values as taught by our symbols, your accomplishments and your accomplishments to come, and to encourage you to do even more in the days ahead to extend those values. With that, we'll move forward with initiating. Initiating our chapter leadership. Since this is the very first initiation ceremony after reactivating the Alpha Tau chapter, it is now my great pleasure and honor to initiate Alpha Tau chapter officers. Jody M. Graff. Jody serves on the chapter leadership board as the vice president. Andrea Sibbenman. Andrea serves on the chapter leadership board as the programming chair. Pauline Beezer James. Pauline serves on the chapter leadership board as our treasurer. And Christine Jerf. Christine serves as the marketing chair on the chapter leadership board. It is now my great pleasure and honor to invest upon you the Medal of the Society and Diploma of Membership and initiate you all into the Phi Beta Delta Honor Society for International Scholars as the chartering officers of the Alpha Tau chapter here at the University of Iowa. I, Yashwant Prakash Vyas, in my capacity as the president, hereby install you as the chartering officers of the Alpha Tau chapter and as member with full privileges in the ambitions and aspirations of Phi Beta Delta Honor Society for International Scholars. I confirm your membership based on the affirmation of your interest in the initiatives and conduct of international scholarship locally and nationally, and on the basis of the confidence invested in you by the governing board of the Alpha Tau chapter at the University of Iowa in their certification that you qualify for membership under the established criteria of the society. You may now wear your medallions. Many congratulations. With that, I will welcome Christine Jerf to lead us further into our ceremony today.
Greetings. My name is Christine Jerf. My pronouns are she, hers, hers. This being a most special occasion, we have requested Dr. Russell Ganim to address the chapter. Russell Ganim is a professor of French and associate provost and dean of international programs at the University of Iowa. He joined the University of Iowa in 2011 as the director of the Division of World Languages, Literatures, and Cultures, and served in this position until 2019. He moved to international programs in 2020. Much of his career has been devoted to shared governance, including service as president of the UI Faculty Senate. He holds an AB from Grinnell College, as well as an MA and PhD from the University of Virginia. Dean Ganim is committed to advocating for international students, increasing study abroad opportunities, and promoting global education across the University of Iowa campus.
Thank you very much, Christine, and thank you, Yashwant. It is an absolute delight to be here, and good afternoon, everyone. So I am honored to deliver the opening remarks for the Fall 2020 initiation ceremony of the Phi Beta Delta Honor Society for International Scholars, specifically for the new Alpha Tau chapter at the University of Iowa. The Office of International Programs is most pleased to collaborate with the Division of Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion on reviving our local chapter of Phi Beta Delta after several years of inactivity. I personally have considerable experience with Phi Beta Delta, as I was a member at my former institution, the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. At Nebraska, I came to understand the important role Phi Beta Delta plays in bringing together faculty, staff, and students, both international and domestic, to raise awareness around issues surrounding global education and to provide a venue for those committed to promoting international experiences and perspectives. Phi Beta Delta allows those devoted to global learning and cooperation to meet, to hold lectures and symposia, and simply to socialize. It is only fitting that we choose International Education Week to officially recognize the reopening of our chapter here at Iowa. Global education and understanding are especially important in this challenging environment. The problems we face will require international collaboration if they are to be resolved. Phi Beta Delta advances the idea that this cooperation starts locally, with people-to-people interaction that builds communities among many different interests and constituencies. Please let me congratulate the inductees not simply on recognizing the importance of global education, but by demonstrating time and again their commitment to promoting objectives that foster connections and enable us to learn from one another across cultures, languages, and worldviews. Please know that you will always have the support of the Office of International Programs as you continue this invaluable work. I will now return the platform to Yash Wandt so that he may begin the initiation of the new members. Thank you.
Thank you, Dean Ghanem. We will now proceed to initiating our new members from the spring 2020 and fall 2020 semesters. But before we confirm the membership on our new members and officially welcome them into the society, I would like to share with you all the membership criteria to be welcomed into the society. Membership in the society is open to individuals who have demonstrated scholarly achievement in the areas of international educational interchange. These individuals include international students on non-immigrant visas in upper division or graduate or professional levels who have demonstrated high scholastic achievement at the University of Iowa, which means undergraduate students must have completed 45 session hours here at the University of Iowa with a cumulative GPA of 3.2 or above. Graduate and professional students must have completed one semester in a one-year master's degree, two semesters in a two-year master's degree, or two semesters in a doctoral degree program here at the University of Iowa with a cumulative GPA of 3.5 or above. Student must be in a good standing, that is good academic and code of student life standing with the University of Iowa at the time of application. Domestic students in upper division and graduate and professional levels who have demonstrated high scholastic achievement in their pursuit of international educational interchange through a University of Iowa recognized study abroad or work or internship abroad program. Whereas undergraduate students who have participated in these endeavors must have completed 45 session hours at the University of Iowa with a cumulative GPA of 3.2 or above. Graduate and professional students must have completed one semester in a one-year master's program, two semesters in a two-year master's degree program, or two semesters in a doctoral degree program at the University of Iowa with a cumulative GPA of 3.5 or above. Student must also be in good academic and score of student life standing with the University of Iowa at the time of application. Staff, faculty, postdoctoral fellows, and visiting scholars who have been involved in a University of Iowa recognized international endeavors, which include but are not limited to international research, research collaborations, teaching, program development, or services. Keeping these membership criteria established by the Alpha Tau chapter in accordance with the society bylaws, Vice President Graf, do individuals on our list for initiation today meet the membership criteria and have their credentials been verified?
Yes, their credentials have been verified and they all meet the membership criteria. You may proceed.
Thank you, Jody. I, Yashwant Prakash Vyas, in my capacity as the president, hereby install you as members with full privileges in the ambitions and aspirations of Phi Beta Delta Honor Society for International Scholars. I confirm your membership based on the affirmation of your interest in the initiatives and conduct of international scholarship locally and nationally, and on the basis of the confidence invested in you by the governing board of the Alpha Tau chapter at the University of Iowa in their certification that you qualify for membership under the established criteria of the society. You may now wear your medallions. Many congratulations and welcome to Phi Beta Delta Honor Society for International Scholars. With that, we will now welcome and recognize each of our members who were conferred membership in the spring 2020 and fall 2020 semesters. Given that we are conducting this ceremony virtually, we have prepared graphics to recognize each of our new members. And with that, I would like to welcome Andrea to help lead us further into our ceremony today.
Thank you, Yashwant. So the first in list is Janine Porter Abrams.
Congratulations and welcome.
Oz Abuzaid.
Congratulations and welcome.
Sukaina Albazrun.
Congratulations and welcome.
Yasmin Albayat.
Congratulations and welcome.
Olivia Christine Alders.
Congratulations and welcome to the society.
Ahmad Al-Ghazali. Alan Arakal.
Congratulations and welcome.
Muhammad Farid Arif.
Congratulations and welcome.
Kendall Henry Arthur.
Congratulations and welcome.
Miat Finzar Ong. Wahid Awotoye.
Congratulations and welcome.
Owen Baldwin.
Congratulations and welcome.
Elizabeth Barrett.
Congratulations and welcome.
Ali K. Bestel.
Congratulations and welcome.
Divya Bhagyanad.
Congratulations and welcome.
Jennifer A. Blair.
Congratulations and welcome.
Joelle Ann Brown.
Congratulations and welcome.
Alice Kale Finnegan.
Congratulations and welcome.
Yichong Cao. Tatiana Castillo.
Congratulations and welcome.
Bharat Chandra.
Congratulations and welcome.
Peichi Chen.
Congratulations and welcome.
Yue Chen.
Congratulations and welcome.
Heather Chuang.
Congratulations, welcome.
Chloe Clemenson.
Congratulations and welcome.
Brett Cloyd.
Congratulations and welcome.
Joanne Constantine.
Congratulations and welcome.
Anna B. Correa.
Congratulations and welcome.
Xiao Tong Ding.
Congratulations and welcome.
Nazmin Etty.
Congratulations and welcome.
When you find.
Congratulations and welcome.
Brian R. Farrell.
Congratulations and welcome.
Denise Filios.
Congratulations and welcome.
Venkateshwaran Ganesh.
Congratulations and welcome.
Valerie S. Gar.
Congratulations and welcome.
Brianna Joy Grant.
Congratulations and welcome.
Charlotte Goody.
Congratulations and welcome.
Junho Ha.
Congratulations and welcome.
Chongzi Han.
Congratulations and welcome.
Mary Hartle.
Congratulations and welcome.
Obada Hussein Ali Hassan.
Congratulations and welcome.
Aida Hassanova.
Congratulations and welcome.
Alicia Muriel Hine.
Congratulations and welcome.
Allison M. Herr.
Congratulations and welcome.
Sloan Hoover.
Congratulations and welcome.
Hannah Rose Huzzy.
Congratulations and welcome.
Krishnamurthy IR.
Congratulations and welcome.
Madeline Germier.
Congratulations and welcome.
Alice Jung.
Congratulations and welcome.
Zane Johnson.
Congratulations and welcome.
Riel Jones Teske.
Congratulations and welcome.
Natasha Cott.
Congratulations and welcome.
Hey Sun Kim.
Congratulations and welcome.
Jiwon Kim.
Congratulations and welcome.
Sohyun Kim.
Congratulations and welcome.
Zuzana Kochish.
Congratulations and welcome.
Teresa A. Kaut.
Congratulations and welcome.
Diba Kwanar.
Congratulations and welcome.
Chen Shi Li.
Congratulations and welcome.
Yawei Li.
Congratulations and welcome.
Katina Lilios.
Congratulations and welcome.
Juhoy Lin.
Congratulations and welcome.
The Yu Lu.
Congratulations and welcome.
Andrea Lee Lynch.
Congratulations and welcome.
Kelsey Lyons.
Congratulations and welcome.
Kaidi Meng.
Congratulations and welcome.
Hannah Olivia Moore.
Congratulations and welcome.
Ashley Justine Morrow.
Congratulations and welcome.
Chandan Balaganchi Narayan.
Congratulations and welcome.
Alina Nowicki.
Congratulations and welcome.
Ryan Oreda.
Congratulations and welcome.
Brandon Henning Paul.
Congratulations and welcome.
Sai Meghana Palagiri.
Congratulations and welcome.
Iris Ann Pyman.
Congratulations and welcome.
Bailey C. Peterson.
Congratulations and welcome.
Niroda R. Pitawilla.
Congratulations and welcome.
Sarah K. Poultney.
Congratulations and welcome.
Fayaz Rahman.
Congratulations and welcome.
Raghu Ramanathan.
Congratulations and welcome.
Samuel Carl Reinhold.
Congratulations and welcome.
Marisa Rethman.
Congratulations and welcome.
Ana M. Rodriguez Rodriguez.
Congratulations and welcome.
Sanjeev Saha.
Congratulations and welcome.
Suraj Mohan Saxena.
Congratulations and welcome.
Jonathan Sanford.
Congratulations and welcome.
Morten Schlutta.
Congratulations and welcome.
Yusuf Sermet.
Congratulations and welcome.
Francesca Spencer.
Congratulations and welcome.
Maria Grazia Stanko.
Congratulations and welcome.
Holly Elena Stevenson.
Congratulations and welcome.
Ningxin Su.
Congratulations and welcome.
Hongtao Sun.
Congratulations and welcome.
Sophie Switzer.
Congratulations and welcome.
Hanxi Tang.
Congratulations and welcome.
Jun Tang.
Congratulations and welcome.
Brooke Timmerman.
Congratulations and welcome.
Manda Tiwari.
Congratulations and welcome.
Mary Trainer.
Congratulations and welcome.
Moon Lei Tong.
Congratulations and welcome.
Anna E. Turnquist.
Congratulations and welcome.
Paula Palino Ramos.
Congratulations and welcome.
Jan Van Robes.
Congratulations and welcome.
Graciela Webby.
Congratulations and welcome.
Christina L. Vensky.
Congratulations and welcome.
Drew Matthew Waltz.
Congratulations and welcome.
Dan Wong.
Congratulations and welcome.
Nong Mingzhu Wang.
Congratulations and welcome.
Yahua Wang.
Congratulations and welcome.
Yao Ming Wang.
Congratulations and welcome.
Yang.
Congratulations and welcome.
Carlette Washington Hoagland.
Congratulations and welcome.
Jins.
Congratulations and welcome.
Nicole Wendell.
Congratulations and welcome.
Samantha Wiedner.
Congratulations and welcome.
Miranda Rose Wilson.
Congratulations and welcome.
Alexis Winicky.
Congratulations and welcome.
Carly Witherall.
Congratulations and welcome.
Lauren Elizabeth Wood.
Congratulations and welcome.
Wang Jun Xu.
Congratulations and welcome.
Jirong Yi.
Congratulations and welcome.
Wang Yip Wu.
Congratulations and welcome.
Jianning Yun.
Congratulations and welcome.
Mingying Zhang.
Congratulations and welcome.
Hao Zhou.
Congratulations and welcome. With that, once again, many congratulations on your distinction as an international scholar, and many congratulations on your many achievements and your achievements to come. Welcome to Phi Beta Delta Honor Society for International Scholars.
Greetings.
Thank you, Andrea. With that, I will invite Jody to lead us further into our ceremony today.
Thank you, Yashwant. Greetings, my name is Jody Graff and my pronouns are she and hers. And I serve as the Vice President for Phi Beta Delta Honor Society for International Scholars Alpha Tau Chapter. It's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Liz Tovar to address the chapter with closing remarks. Dr. Tovar is the Interim Associate Vice President for Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion in the Office of the Provost at the University of Iowa. This is Dr. Tovar's eighth year as the Associate Athletic Director within the Department of Athletics in the Student Athlete Academic Services Office. Dr. Tovar received her undergraduate, master's, and doctorate degree in psychology, clinical psychology, and educational leadership and policy studies, respectively, from the University of Kansas. Before joining in Iowa in 2013, she managed student services and advised student athletes in academic, personal, and professional development at KU. Ohio State University in Columbus, Ohio, and Northern Illinois University in DeKalb, Illinois. Please welcome Dr. Tavar.
Thank you, Jody. I really appreciate that warm welcome. And let me just start out by saying just how impressed I really am with all of the individuals who are on the line today and being recognized and initiated into such a wonderful opportunity. Let me just take a moment to just say thank you to Yashwant for number one, asking me to be here today. I know you were very instrumental in bringing this program to Iowa, so I just wanted to thank you for that. And I'd also like to thank Dr. Gannon as well and his staff for just continuing to be a champion for international students and also international experiences. I've had the opportunity to be here at the University of Iowa for, you know, the past 7 years. I've loved my experience here. And most importantly, I've loved the opportunity to be able to engage with the international community. And I'm going to keep my remarks brief today because Yashwant told me, he says, now Liz, you can only keep this to 5 minutes. So I will keep it to 5 minutes. I do promise you that. But thank you. Thank you all for all that you do. I know there's about 128 faculty, students, and staff being recognized today. And what I really appreciate about this event is that it gives us an opportunity to celebrate the importance of, you know, our values here at the University of Iowa, and we value the international experience. I realize that the year 2020 has just been marked with a great deal of challenges, the pandemic, racial and social unrest, online virtual learning. I mean, you name it, we've experienced it this year. But and I can only imagine the level of, you know, just uncertainty that has had on our international community. However, I will tell you this, I applaud the continued momentum to advance the educational interchange of information and research that we have going on here at Iowa. In spite of all of these challenges that we've had, you know, I think it's really important to continue to recognize this particular group and to recognize all of your achievements that you've accomplished. What I'm also very, very proud of is that I see a great deal of diversity represented here today. I think there's a terrific mix between international students and also domestic students, you know, visiting scholars, postdoctoral fellows, faculty, staff. I just love it. And, you know, with that being said, I also think that it's important to recognize that this program really demonstrates to me that here at Iowa, we have a vast number of scholars participating in things like study abroad, internship experiences abroad, teaching, studying abroad, international research collaborations and programs really geared towards the development of the international experience. So with that being said, let me just say thank you. Congratulations. I applaud your leadership, your success and continued efforts to help us really navigate a more global society. And I really think it's essential that all of us as Hawkeyes really understand the importance of a global education. As the head of the Division of Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion, I really challenge you to continue research, discussion, and really promote scholarly work that encourages and highlights diversity of thought, and to really think innovatively about how we can continue to unify not only our country, but our global community as well. So with that being said, congratulations. Thank you all so much. And I look forward to hopefully meeting many of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Tovar. We appreciate you joining us today and sharing your remarks with us. With that, I want to take this opportunity and to thank the Alpha Tau Leadership Board in their efforts, in their service, in their leadership in making this initiative on our campus successful. We started sometime last fall, and since then they have their leadership and their service have been unwavering through everything that we have seen in the past year. And so thank you for your leadership and for your support of international educational interchange on our campus. So let's appreciate our chapter leadership board once again, and before we close our meeting today. With that, one final announcement. The graphics that we have created for our recognition today will be available on our Facebook page. And so you can download those graphics from our Facebook page if you would like to. And that information is available on our chapter website. If you just Google Phi Beta Delta UIOWA, you should be able to locate our website. With that, so may there ever be your preoccupations. Our earnest desire is that because of what you achieve as leaders, that the values of Phi Beta Delta will be extended and that the world will be surprised by the goodly influence you generate. I now declare this special initiation meeting of the Alpha Tau chapter of Phi Beta Delta Honor Society for International Scholars to be closed.